Good afternoon. It's actually just gone midday. Sun is shining. It is cold out there because I've been out there once already. There's still a little bit of frost hanging around in the shade. I've still got that lot down there to get down the dump. It's just finding the time to do it at the moment. Anyway, I've just spent the last 2 days at Mum's wiring up the new workshop. All the electrics are done. Finished it yesterday. And the circuit breakers in the workshop decided to be a bit of a pain. I thought I'd check the RCD because I realised what I thought was actually just an on-off switch, a main switch, was actually an RCD, residual current device. I could have just used it as a main switch, but I thought just for the extra protection, I'll wire it up as an RCD. And I hit the test button, and it tripped fine. And it was one of them, to reset it, you had to pull the switch down and then put it back up into the on position. Well, it wouldn't work. It wouldn't click. And we tried all sorts. We tried turning the power off in the house and back on and whatnot. And in the end, I got hold of a screwdriver and just tapped the RCD with the screwdriver handle. And it worked. It actually clicked down and then clicked up. And then a little while later, my brother is using the chop saw to cut the feather edge boarding to size for the door, and it trips the 16 amp circuit breaker, which I thought was quite odd because, you know, it's running on a 13 amp fuse. It's not tripping in the main house, it's just tripping here. So I clicked it on, it, you know, it switched back on fine. My brother went to turn it on again, it tripped out again. So I thought, what the heck? So I said, to him, unplug the circuit, the chop saw, so did. Went to reset it, and it just moved up and down. There was no click or anything. As soon as I clicked it up, let go, it just switched straight back off. So I thought, right, maybe there's still a fault on the circuit, you know, something's still plugged in. The only other thing plugged in was a battery charger. We unplugged that. Still no joy. So I thought, maybe there's a problem on the sockets. You know, a wire may have slipped out or something touching the earth. So I went to the first socket outlet on the circuit, took that off the wall, completely disconnected it, all three wires, the earth, the live and the neutral, and still the circuit breaker would not switch back on. So that indicated it was the circuit breaker at fault, not the circuit. Because I disconnected the circuit, so it couldn't be the circuit. So I did the same again. I got the screwdriver, gave the circuit breaker a few firm taps, and it just switched back on. And later in the afternoon, my stepdad used a chop saw again, and it was fine. So maybe it was just because it sat, you know, doing nothing for a while, and they just got a bit temperamental. Yep. Speaking of my brother, he has just messaged me. I better read it. Yeah, why? He wants to know if I'm about, so I said, yeah, why? Oh yeah, I was giving these a little test run. Charged them up last night and left them on. I didn't notice till I went to, you know, plug them in to use them. But the battery's held up fine. So that's good. And they sound great. They're not actually too bassy, so they're not, you know, giving me a headache from bass. But they're not tinny either. There's enough bass for my ears there. So yeah, they work. And they go right up to the bathroom, so every time I need a pee, I haven't got to take the headphones off and pause music to go for a pee. I can just get up and go. Yeah. Yeah, might as well. I've got nothing else to do today. I was going to go around town, but they had cancelled this morning. But now apparently they can pick me up and we can get some stuff moved at Buxton. I don't know why they cancelled it this morning. It's not a problem. But hang on just a second. Alright, just replied to my brother. And I had a present in the mail this morning. I got my first batch of track, which has now enabled me to completely complete this side and make a start down there. So I've got to there. So I've just got to wait for my pack of 12 to arrive, which should go from there to there. And if my calculations are correct, I should have at least 2 straights left over to start on the siding. And at some point I'm going to put the flexi track on there. In fact, I could do that now while I'm a thinking of it. That's what I like about this flexi track. Flexible. There we go. Wondering if I could get a screw through those to hold that flexi track in position. I don't know if that would actually work. Let's just move the boards out of the way. Bloody cat hair. Right. Something like that, I think. Yeah, I'm going to have it end somewhere here. Obviously, again, not too close because of the bend, and the train will catch on it when it goes around the bend. So, as long as there's enough to get at least a short freight in here to use the gantry crane when it's needed. I was actually going to use these base plates. I think I might, actually. So the railway line comes on one side and the road on the other side. Yeah. Because I was just going to use all those light grey base plates, but I think I'll use these. So I'm actually, to complete this bit, I'm only going to need about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, maybe 7 straights. Actually, no, I think 6 would do it. I'm probably going to need about another 12 to do the siding as well. So if I actually went out and bought another 20 straights, that should give me more than enough. Should give me more than enough. I hope it does. Alright, so I've got to go downstairs in about 10 minutes. Oh, I'm going to meet them there, then go over to Buxton. Right. So I've got to plate that out with dark grey boards, and I'm probably going to need a load of these, otherwise it's going to look a little too odd. Oh, I might actually have to go and answer a call of nature before we go. Anyway. One more thing about Lego while I'm here. I'm going to change the base that that is sitting on to these, because it's got these on the bottom. You know, the reason these were called base plates is because you can't connect these. You can only build on the top, not the bottom. Because they sit nice and flat and were great for surfaces like this. But what I'm going to do is put these boards, which I'll only need two of, and I'm pretty certain I've got two. Yes. On the bottom of that police station, and then I'm going to build like concrete supports. Well, I say concrete supports, that's what they're going to resemble anyway. Out of some grey brick, which I've got. I have it like sitting on raised supports over there. Just to give, I don't know, some architectural variations so everything's not built flat, you know. On the one level, that's the reason I dropped this level. Because I might have only a small area to do this on, but I do want to get as much variation in here as possible. And the train is will add a bit of life to the town, if you like, when that's going round and round the track. That's why I wanted the train. Well, that's one of the many reasons I wanted the train. I always wanted a train set, either a train set or a Lego train when I was younger, so getting the Lego train has sort of killed two birds with one stone, I suppose. I've got the train set I've always wanted, and I've got the Lego train I always wanted, and I've got the town to go with it, so really can't complain. Oh yeah, I'm going to have to get it to do, I think. Right. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I need at least 6 green base plates as well to do over there, but it'll be alright for now. I think it's just these corners that might slide a little bit because they don't line up with the studs to grip. So I've only got the straight sort of pressed down. That doesn't matter, it'll hold it in place enough. I mean, by the time I get the base plates in there and these straights pushed down and the same over there, it shouldn't move too much. And should help to hold all this road stuff together because it does like to slide around. Which is highly frustrating because if I so much, you know, as knock the corner, it just throws everything off and then I've got to sit there and line it all up again. But I don't want to glue anything to the table because if I want to rearrange anything again, which could actually, could be likely, you know, I'm not going to sit here and say, nope, never happened, but the chances are I could end up changing the layout and moving buildings around, so I don't really want to super glue any of the boards down, and plus it'll damage them if I ever wanted to sell anything on. So that's why I've got all these little plates like that right there. It's just holding the joints together for now. Anywho, I've got to grab a cordless. I just hope my clerk is charged enough. And I'll put a screwdriver bit in it. Grab that bag of bits. If I've got time, I'll take the lights down in the workshop that we want. In fact, it wouldn't take 2 minutes. While the lads are doing other things, maybe. But I suppose I better just shut the camera down. I might take the camera with me. Yeah, we'll do that, so I'll talk to you a bit later. Here we are. See, them two lights aren't going to be enough, so I've just stuck this one up. That's connected. All I've got to do, I need a rag or something to clean that tube. And then that can go back. All I've got to do is terminate the wires into this one. And that's that job done. And then I'm going to come off the lighting circuit from inside the fuse box. Ouch. Simple. I thought I might as well. Obviously, I'm not going to do that tonight because I need the lights on to see what I'm doing. But I can't do that live. So I'll have to wait until another day. But this one's going to go up here and it's going to be on a separate switch, probably on this wall or on the back wall. Because he's only going to need that on as and when he's using it, so. But yeah, it's a wee bit dark down this side. spare light nonetheless, and I've got another little one up mine. Right. Yeah, I don't know if I'm going to bother. I might do that one. Just got all the cable clipped in nicely. But yeah. With this, I'm just going to go in here and tap off the cable that's running out to those lights. That's the RCD that was being a pain yesterday, and that was the circuit breaker that was being a pain. Right, I better crack on. Right, they're both terminated and up. So, if I get a chance tomorrow, we're bringing some more stuff over from the old workshop, aren't we, Esther? Chuck that cable in there and all the lights are done, apart from the end one. So, on that note, I'll talk to you when I get home. Right, I'm back home. I'll sit you up here on top of the microwave for the time being. I've got a few bits and bobs to sort. Feeding the cat is one of them. Just top your dish up, your water dish. Carrier bags coming out of my behind. Yeah, what my stepdad gave me today. I don't know what watch it is. 25 watt Weller. Soldering iron. May need a new tip, but Weller is good. He's already got a Weller one. He's got like a little mini soldering station he uses. Ice cream in the fridge. Freezer, rather, not the fridge. I have done that before and then couldn't find my ice cream and found a liquid form of it in the fridge. Yeah. Plenty of tuna for some tuna there for Pete's sake. For tuna sandwiches later, because no doubt I'll get a bit peckish. I forgot me bubble wrap. I'm just gonna, because we're gonna get some more stuff out of the old workshop tomorrow, I was gonna get that parcel booked and drop it off at a parcel shop this time, drop off point, whatever you wanna call it, instead of have them pick it up, but I think I'll have them pick it up. I think I'll have a break Thursday and get them to pick it up then. Right, I'll sign it in. Oh dear, right. Pardon me. I had salad for dinner and all I can taste is spring onions now. Right, well, don't the workshop look a lot different now? It's actually looking like a workshop. All I've got to do when I get back from the old workshop to Mum's is just to connect those lights up the way I said it was. I was just going to tap into the line that goes to the other lights. It was just easier to tap into it from the fuse box than it would be to, you know, run the cable round from the other side, especially as I've got that other light to fit up. I'm going to need a single back box, aren't I? And there should be some white trunking at the old workshop, some of this stuff, because I've done such a decent job, I don't want to spoil it by clipping a grey cable up the wall. So I need to find a light switch. I should have a back box somewhere that I can use. I'll take the switch off this because it's a double pole switch, not a proper light switch. I could use that one, but I will have a dig around in there because I should have some more. If not, I've got a feeling they're down in the shed and I don't particularly want to go and get them out of the shed. Because I've got to empty like 3 or 4 bikes out as well as a big pile of wheels. I don't really want to do all that early in the morning, so. And I'm not sure what I can pinch at the old workshop because I can't remember what's there. I've got to turn this one on. I've got to sort the blank plates out on the front there because I've fallen through. I've got to message a friend of mine on Facebook to tell him I'm home. Like so. Boot that one up because I burnt some discs off last night and they didn't work. I can see the ring around the edge of the DVD where the burner burnt up to, but I put them in 2 different computers at Mum's and they both said they were blank discs, so I got to sort that. So I'm going to do that with that one. That one likes to take its sweet time to boot up. My items, my other track and my Build-A-Bears, my Build-A-Bear ponies, aren't marked as shipped yet. But that doesn't always mean anything, because I know some sellers forget to mark them as shipped. You know, I've been waiting for them to be marked as shipped and they've actually turned up on my doorstep. Not often, but it does happen. I'm actually quite pleased with this. This is coming out really, really nice. So I need, what did I say this morning? I need about 4, at least 5, I think, straights in here. Like I said, I can't go too close to the corner, otherwise the train won't be able to go round. Yeah. I am really, I'm really happy with this, with this town. Ooh, you know, they always say that people with autism have obsessions rather than interests. Sort of is and isn't true. I mean, I've got lots of things that interest me. I mean, if I had the room and the cash to spare, I would have a lot more hobbies than what I've already got. I've got 2 main hobbies, we'll say, or 2 main interests. My Lego and My Little Pony. I'm not actually sure if I'd class that as a hobby. That would be an interest, wouldn't it? So I'll say my Lego is my hobby. My Little Pony is an interest. And I suppose playing around and building with computers is another hobby. I've got those old bicycles that I kept deliberately. So I do like having a ride on the old ones. Sliding back and forth, multitasking. I have got a My Little Pony related video that I want to do, but I'm going to wait until these Build-A-Bears arrive in the mail. Not that one. I'm not going to that one. Right. I was going to play around with some Lego when I got home, but I am actually feeling too knackered. Because I was going to put the police station over there on those new bases and the new stilts and try and get that in place, but I was not asking your opinion. But I am feeling too knackered to do that. And I had an accident with that Lego set. Oopsie, I kicked it with my foot, so I've got to... I might actually demolish that and totally rebuild it, because I don't actually know what parts are missing now. Now I've pretty much demolished it, so... That's me and my big size 9s. Right, so the plan for tomorrow, unless it changes in the morning... I'm going to get picked up. I think my brother's got work, so he won't be with us. Unless, of course, his boss changes his mind and say, no, don't need you in this morning. But we're going to go over to the other workshop. I've left my cordless drill in the car, so we've got one each. So we can just go around and take down any storage containers and whatnot that we might need. A lot quicker if there's two of us. There's some cabinets we want to take down as well that he's going to bring. Not all of the workbench in the old workshop, just a couple of sections of it. We've got a couple of dump runs he's planning to do. Well, we've got to do a dump run because we've got to empty the trailer. If we use that one, he might use the landlord's, if the landlord lets him. But I hate that trailer. It is a dodgy piece of crap to pull. I was actually watching it in the side mirror on the car because I was keeping an eye on the ratchet strap buckle because it did come loose once. So I was watching it and I could just see it. It bounces all over the place, and then we were only doing 55, if that, and I could see the trailer gently snaking from side to side. It's a horrible trailer to pull. That little one my stepdad built pulls a darn sight better. But I think what we've got there, if we pack the trailer and the car right, we could actually get quite a bit over tomorrow. Then I think it would just be what's left in the garden. Yep, I think it'll be what is left in the garden. There's some bits in the wooden shed, but I think most of that is just junk. Apart from the garden tools, the lawnmower, and the garden ornaments, and that's it. Yeah, that is it. Sign into Skype as well. I am feeling that I could quite easily go to bed. Right now. Plug my headphones in. You're probably wondering why I don't leave things like this plugged in when I'm not here. Well, it's because I know that there's always a risk that something like these little adapters could go faulty and start a fire. Or the rechargeable batteries and things could also go faulty and trigger a fire. So I could be just being a little bit paranoid, but I don't like to leave anything on charge unless I'm here. If I'm not here, it gets unplugged. So yeah. On that note though, I think I'm going to shut down the camera. If I remember, I've got some rubbish to take down in the morning. I don't think my friend has sent a message yet. Not unless he's walking over now, I don't know. He's only just down the road from me, literally. What? I could have a play with the train. I just want my extra track so I can complete the loop. that I can just sit here, set it going, and just leave it until the batteries die or something. That's the only downfall with these trains, they're battery operated. Which is why I'm going to use rechargeables. I'm going to get some brand new ones for it. Runs on AAAs. So next time Lidl's have their rechargeable batteries in, I'll get a couple of packs of AAAs. Because they're only $2.99 and they've been, so far, a good battery. So I've got several kicking around. But, yeah, so I'll get some rechargeables to stick in that. Not worried so much about the controller, because it's just a remote control, basically. Because it uses infrared, so it's just like, you know, a TV remote. It uses very little current, so the batteries should last a fair while in the controller itself. Mm-hmm. I'm going to open up and see what's in there, because I might stick some Duracell or something in there. Something I know that's quality and gonna last. I've seen YouTubers say, you know, it doesn't matter. You know, sometimes the cheaper ones are just as good as the expensive ones, but in my own experience, I do find that brands like Duracell, Energizer, Eveready tend to last a lot longer. Anyway, I'm rambling on, so I'm going to disappear. Get these discs sorted out, I hope. I'm going to try using a different DVD, because I used these ones yesterday, so I don't know if they're maybe a dodgy brand or something. What are they CDs or... They're CDRs as well, I'm nuts. Don't tell me they're the only DVDs I've got. I've got absolutely stacks of CDs here. Oh well. Guess I'm going to try another one of them then, so stick this in. There we go. I'm going to test the CDs before I take them, because I want to upgrade Mum's laptop as well. And get my brother's working, but... both machines said the discs were blank. Anyway, I'll shut the video down because I am getting tired. Despite eating dinner like 2 hours ago, I'm getting peckish again. But then again, I only had a sandwich this morning, so... Thanks for watching. If you liked the video, hit the like button. If you didn't, hit the dislike button. And... subscribe if you haven't already, and if you want to, I'm not going to force you, it's up to you. Much appreciated if you do, and thanks in advance, and I'll talk to you again tomorrow, maybe, when I get back from Mum's. If I'm not too tired, or I might take a break. We'll see. Anyway, thanks for watching. See you later.